The Kamov Ka-50, also known as the Werewolf or Black Shark, is one of the most unique and versatile rotary-wing aircraft ever produced. The Russian helicopter has risen to fame for its coaxial rotor system, which eliminates the need for a tail rotor and enhances its speed and maneuverability. When introduced, the Black Shark also became the first helicopter to feature an ejection seat. This characteristic made it so popular that the company produced a two-seat variant, dubbed the Ka-52 Alligator. Since then, Kamov has come up with different variants with unique features tailored specifically to the buyer, such as the Egyptian Nile Crocodile, with an anti-corrosion coating and an improved cooling system, or the Mud Shark, a naval variant suited for Russian carrier use. The successful Russian helicopter keeps showing its unquestionable prowess, and as long as Kamov keeps updating it with the latest technology, the dangerous predators will continue leaving their mark around the world. Kamov V-80 program. The Russian military learned the hard way that it required a new attack helicopter during the Soviet-Afghan War. Development of a new rotary-wing aircraft had already begun in the late 1970s with the Kamov V-80 design study. The prototype was a support helicopter that would protect ground troops from hostile enemy aircraft with a fixed cannon and air-to-air missiles. However, the introduction of the American AH-64 Apache helicopter dramatically changed the program's objectives. The Kamov and Mil Moscow design bureaus submitted two designs to win a contract for the USSR's most powerful helicopter, and in 1980, Kamov began developing two test helicopters, dubbed V-80. Kamov engineers believed their new design could be based on the humble Kamov Ka-25 naval helicopter, which was operated by a single pilot and featured a high degree of automation. But after analyzing how the Mil Mi-24 worked, they concluded that the second crewman was unnecessary. As such, they were able to save weight and space, thus increasing the capacity for additional firepower and fuel and making maintenance easier. More importantly, the engineers combined the automated functions of flying, target acquisition, navigation, and tracking, allowing a single pilot to man the aircraft. The result was the V-80 SH-1 prototype, which featured a coaxial contra-rotating rotor system that removed the need for a tail rotor assembly. This not only saved weight, but allowed the helicopter to increase its aerobatic capabilities. The aircraft also featured an NPP Zvezda K-37-800 ejection seat that increased the pilot's survivability. The way it works is that before the rocket in the seat deploys, the rotor blades are set off with explosive charges in the rotor disc, and the canopy is jettisoned. As such, it became the first helicopter with a rescue ejection system. The Werewolf. The helicopter has a height of 4.93 meters, a weight of 10,800 kilograms, and a span of over 15 meters. The two Klimov TV3 117VK turboshaft engines develop 2,226 horsepower and drive two three-bladed counter-rotating coaxial main rotors. This allows the aircraft to reach a maximum speed of up to 310 kilometers per hour, a rate of climb of 480 meters per minute, and a combat range of over 520 kilometers. The lack of a tail rotor allows it to perform flat turns within the entire flight speed range, and a maximum vertical load factor of 3.5 Gs gives it incredible agility. Following several flight tests in 1982, the V-80 prototype was approved for production under the designation Ka-50. It was publicly unveiled for the first time in March of 1992 during a symposium in the United Kingdom, and then shown at the Mos Aero Show in Zhukovsky in August, as well as the Farnborough Air Show. During the events, the Ka-50 was displayed with the icon of a werewolf on its rudder. From then, the Ka-50 would be known as either the Werewolf or the Black Shark, following the unveiling of the fifth aircraft, which was painted in an all-black palette. Only a dozen werewolves were delivered to the Russian army in the late 1990s, out of an order of more than 200 that were meant to replace the Mil Mi-24. However, production was reactivated in the early 2000s, and several variants of the Ka-50 have been delivered. Black Shark armament. The helicopter's standard armament comprises one 30mm Shipunov 2A42 cannon, fitted along the starboard side of the fuselage. It can fire armor-piercing and high-explosive fragmentation ammunition. Its gun has a muzzle velocity of 980 meters per second and a range of up to 4 kilometers. In addition, the small mid-mounted wings are fitted with 4 underwing suspension units and wingtip pods for additional ordnance. Up to 12 Vikir supersonic anti-tank missiles can be mounted on the external stores. The Black Shark can also carry 12 AS-12 Kegler air-to-surface missiles, 4 Vimpel R-73 short-range missiles, or 4 S-8HE munitions-dispensing rockets. And its countermeasures comprise a radar warning receiver, an electronic warfare system, a flare dispenser, and chaff. Flight systems include a HUD, an inertial navigation system, a forward-looking infrared radar, and a terrain-following radar. The Night Shark. The first batch of werewolves lacked nighttime capabilities because budget issues prevented the helicopter from being equipped with the Mercury low-light TV system. However, Kamov drafted a variant for night combat and introduced it in 1997. The Ka-50N was dubbed the Night Shark and was fitted with FLIR and electro-optic sights, a sub-sheet 50T thermal imager, a laser rangefinder, and several other assets that made it optimal for night operations. Design-wise, the Night Shark retains the same unconventional look of its predecessor, with the cockpit situated forward in the fuselage and the engine placed aft. The only difference resides in the placement of the sub-sheet 50 system, which comes in the form of a 540mm sphere installed under the nose. Ka-52 Alligator. When the original Ka-50 was introduced, Kamov came up with another variant that could coordinate group attack helicopter operations and provide support, target designation, and reconnaissance capabilities. These additional capabilities forcibly required a second crewman to operate the reconnaissance suite. Consequently, Kamov modified a single-seat werewolf with a side-by-side seating arrangement for immediate communication between the two crewmen. This modified helicopter evolved into the Ka-52 Alligator, a two-seat variant of the Black Shark. The Alligator has a less aggressive nose profile and is fitted with a radar system, two antennas, day and night thermal sighting, and the same armament. However, the weight and size increase resulted in slower top speeds and maneuverability. Its twin-seat cockpit features the same innovative ejection system as the Black Shark and its HUD elements. It weighs almost 11,000 kilograms, has a length of 16 meters, a height of 4.9 meters, and a diameter of 14.5 meters. In addition, the Alligator can reach a cruise speed of 460 kilometers, an altitude of 5,500 kilometers, and a ferry range of 1,100 kilometers. The first Alligator was produced in 1996, and its production reached more than a dozen in 2010. It was first introduced to the Russian Armed Forces in 2011, and in February of 2018, the Russian Ministry of Defense announced it would purchase over 100 Ka-52 Alligators as part of an Air Force renovation program that will finish by 2026. The Erdogan. After the formal introduction of the Ka-52 Alligator to the Russian Air Force, the Turkish Air Force was attracted by the Russian design and expressed interest in acquiring some. Between 1997 and 1998, the Kamov Bureau partnered with Israel Aerospace Industries, or IAI, to enter a Turkish competition. The winner would be awarded a $4 billion contract to develop over 140 helicopters to modernize the Turkish armed forces. Kamov and IAI chose the base twin-seat Ka-52 Alligator as their platform and renamed it the Erdogan. The Israeli company fitted the helicopter with state-of-the-art technology, making it more lethal for combat. IAI mainly added advanced glass cockpit avionics and swapped the fixed 30mm cannon for a turret-mounting folding cannon. Additionally, the Israeli company perfected the avionics for enhanced anti-tank combat, bolstering the performance of anti-tank missiles. Despite the enhanced features of the Ka-52 Erdogan, Turkey ultimately settled for another aircraft, and only one Erdogan was completed. Nevertheless, in 2015, Kamov secured a deal with Egypt to develop 50 Ka-52 helicopters for its armed forces. The first batch was delivered in 2017 without any issues. This variant was dubbed the Ka-52 Nile Crocodile, which shares some differences with the standard alligator. For instance, the Nile Crocodile has a reinforced fuselage, is made with anti-corrosion materials, and has a modernized cooling system suited for the harsh and hot Egyptian landscape. The Nile Crocodile also features redesigned landing gear, updated avionics, a revamped laser targeting system, and an Arabalet 52 pulse radar. State-of-the-art variant. When the Russian Navy first deployed its modern Mistral-class amphibious, it envisioned a specialized variant of the Ka-52 for its rotary-wing assets. This led Kamov to develop the Ka-52K Katran, or Mud Shark, a naval variant suited for carrier use. The Mud Shark features folding wings, folding rotor blades, and reinforced landing gear. The shorter wings of the Mud Shark only allow it to carry 4 of the standard 6 weapon pylons of the Alligator. However, the Mud Shark is equipped with a more advanced radar that provides it an increased range for naval operations. The original Ka-50 and its Ka-52 variant have participated in several world conflicts since their introduction. The Ka-50 was used in combat for the first time in the Second Chechen War, and both helicopters were deployed during the Syrian Civil War of 2015. Following the introduction of the last variant, the Russian Ministry of Defense announced in 2019 that all existing Ka-52s were going to be upgraded to the Ka-52M variant, and several models have been spotted recently in Ukraine. Some of the upgrades of the latest Ka-52 variant include a redesigned landing gear, revamped cockpit ergonomics, a more powerful GOES-451M electro-optical targeting turret with better range, redesigned night vision goggles for night operations, and the integration of a new command and control system. Although the Russian ministry did not specify how long and how much it will cost the armed forces to upgrade all the existing Ka-52s, one thing remains certain. More powerful and unique variants will continue to create havoc in the upcoming years. Thank you for watching our video. Please like and subscribe to our Dark Documentaries channels to find more exciting historical and military content. And don't forget to hit the bell icon to be notified of our newest videos. Stay tuned.